In the previous video, we discussed ideal voltage source. Now we discuss ideal current source. So ideal voltage source has zero source resistance, whereas ideal current source has infinite source resistance. So the ideal current source is drawn like this. The ideal current source is drawn in this way. This is current Is. And this is the load. An ideal current source has infinite source resistance. So the infinite source resistance can be replaced by an open circuit. So this is the infinite source resistance. This Rs is infinite. So this infinite source resistance can be replaced by a open circuit. So this is the infinite source resistance. And the voltage across the load is Vt. And current It is flowing through it. So It will always be equal to Is. The current It will always be equal to Is. So if we draw the IV characteristic curve, if we draw the IV characteristic curve, so I have IT on the y-axis and VT on the x-axis. So the current IT is always equal to IS. So it is a horizontal line parallel to the x-axis, where the value of IT is always equal to IS. So the slope is zero. And if we draw the VI characteristic curve, where on y axis we have VT, on x axis I have IT, then IT is always equal to IS. So this is a vertical line parallel to the y axis, parallel to VT. IT is always equal to IS. So the slope here is infinite. So the ideal current source has infinite source resistance, so the infinite source resistance is replaced by an open circuit. So this ideal current source always provides current IS to the load. And the voltage across the load is VT. So IT is always equal to IS. The current flowing through the load is always equal to IS. So the IV characteristic curve is a horizontal line parallel to the x-axis with slope 0. And VI characteristic curve is a vertical line parallel to the y-axis with slope equal to infinite. This is the ideal current source. Note that the source transformation cannot be applied to ideal voltage source or the ideal current source, because the VI characteristics of ideal current source never match. So source transformation cannot be applied to ideal current source or an ideal voltage source. Source transformation can only be applied to practical current source or practical voltage source, which we will see in the next video.